بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Brothers and sisters, you've joined us today on our beautiful show entitled Our Lord Allah سبحانه وتعالى. الحمد لله, we're still joined by our Sheikh, الشيخ سعيد القاضي. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام بارك الله فيك يا أبا هشام.
How are you, Sheikh?
الحمد لله, may Allah bless and reward you.
الحمد لله, ما شاء الله تبارك الله. Sheikh, you know, on this series, we've already discussed the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the, you know, kind of pristine attributes of Allah, the most majestic, the most high. Today, Sheikh, and just to let our brothers and sisters know at home, our discussion is about the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, when we hear that Allah is the all-hearing, the one that hears everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Sheikh, you know, can we actually describe this hearing? Is there any information, are there any clues in the Quran and in the Sunnah that describe for us the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or can we actually, you know, go ahead and describe how the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen, Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. All praise is due to Allah alone, praise Him, thank Him, seek His guidance and His forgiveness. We repent to Him, we seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our soul and our sinful deeds. Whoever Allah guides, none can mislead, and whoever Allah misleads, none can guide. Describing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His attributes, or describing His name subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is beyond our comprehension. It is beyond our understanding. However, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most perfect, free from any deficiency, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the only absolute, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the sustainer, the planner, the master, the provider. He is, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator, azza wa jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls the affairs of the whole universe, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He commands and forbids, He gives and takes. He causes people to die and people to live. He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, causes nations to rise and others to fall, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has embraced everything in His knowledge and He has encompassed everything in His mercy, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He hears everything. He hears all the voices. He hears all the languages. And He, subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing can be hidden from Him, azza wa jal. He can even hear the walking of the black ant on a black rock in the dark night.
Allahu Akbar.
So nothing can be hidden from Allah the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the Quran, Allah ta'ala on many occasions spoke about His attribute, the all hearing. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the peak of excellence of this attribute. That He hears everything. Nothing can be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He hears the public, and He hears the secret, and He hears that which is even more hidden. Subhanallah. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَلَهُ مَا سَكَنَ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَلَهُ مَا سَكَنَ فِي اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمِ. That to Allah belongs whatever rests by day and by night. And Allah Ta'ala is the all-hearing, and Allah Ta'ala is the all-knowing, Azza wa Jal. And furthermore, Allah Ta'ala said addressing the wrongdoers, أَمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّا لَا نَسْمَعُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ. What made them transgressing towards us? What made them arrogant? What made them heedless of us? What made them mindless of us? Is it because they don't believe that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is aware of what they say? That Allah Ta'ala hears what they say. أَمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّا لَا نَسْمَعُ سِرَّهُمْ وَنَجْوَاهُمْ. Do they think that Allah Ta'ala cannot hear their public and their secret? بَلَا نَيْ وَرُسُلُنَا لَدَيْهِمْ يَكْتُبُونَ. Nay, we can hear that. Indeed, we can hear that. We do. And our messengers or our angels are by them recording what they are uttering. SubhanAllah.
SubhanAllah, this is very deep. It just shows how close Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to us. And how aware He is, subhanahu wa ta'ala, of what we do and the intricacies of what is hidden and what is apparent, subhanAllah.
Nothing can be hidden from Allah the Almighty. Allah Ta'ala in the Quran said, وَإِن تَجَهَرْ بِالْقَوْلِ فَإِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى. And if you even if you speak aloud, Allah Ta'ala knows that which is secret and that which is yet even hidden, subhanAllah. Even the hidden, the one which is more hidden than the secret, Allah Ta'ala is aware of it.
SubhanAllah.
Even when you speak to yourself now, when you talk to yourself,
yes,
no one in this universe knows what you're saying to yourself.
Yes.
But Allah Ta'ala knows that.
Allahu Akbar.
What you hide inside your chest of feeling, of thought, Allah knows about it. Allah Ta'ala, the Quran told us about this saying, قُلْ إِن تُخْفُوا مَا فِي صُدُورِكُمْ أَوْ تُبْدُوهُ يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهُ. Whether you conceal that which is inside your chest or you reveal it, Allah knows it. وَيَعْلَمُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. And he knows everything in the heaven and everything on earth. وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ. And Allah Ta'ala able to do all things.
Is anything from the Sunnah which describes for us, you know, the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this attribute?
Many ahadith, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said,
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اللهم صلى وسلم,
إن الله لا يسمع دبيب النمرة السوداء على الصخرة المساء في ظلمة الليل. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala indeed can hear everything, and he can even hear the walking of the black ant on a dark rock in the darkness of the night. Subhanallah.
لا إله إلا الله.
So Allah Ta'ala can hear everything. Can hear everything, and nothing can be hidden from Allah the Almighty. In Surah Al-Mujadala,
okay,
this chapter begins, it is called Mujadala.
Mm-hmm.
It denotes to a story that took place between the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and
sallallahu alayhi
a woman who came to him to ask him a question. And Aisha radiallahu anha was in the same room. And she said, glory be to the one whom his hearing has encompassed everything. Glory be to whom his hearing has encompassed and embraced everything. I was in the same room with them and I was unable to hear many things they were talking about. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above his seven heavens, he managed to hear everything.
Allahu Akbar.
Not only Allah ta'ala heard her, qad, just to confirm, okay, sami'a, Allah heard, indeed Allah heard, qawla, and the statement, allati tujadiluka, the woman who is arguing with you concerning her husband. She was saying to him, O Rasulullah, Messenger of Allah, how come you divorced me and I was old woman, unable to provide myself and so on and so forth. He was with me when I was young and now he left me while I'm old. So she was arguing with him, how come he divorced me or he does dihar on me? So Allah Ta'ala from above his heavens, he heard her complaining. وَتَشْتَكِي إِلَى اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ يَسْمَعُ تَحَاوُرَكُمَا. And she is comparing to Allah Ta'ala, and Allah Ta'ala indeed, he hears whatever you say. He hears your conversation.
لا إله إلا الله.
إن الله سميع بصير. Indeed, Allah Ta'ala is all hearing and the all seer, سبحانه وتعالى. Nothing can be hidden from Allah the Almighty, Azza wa Jal.
الله أكبر.
سبحان الله.
So this is an amazing attribute, Shaykh, subhanAllah. You know, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is able to see what we conceal within ourselves even as well.
He
and what we show in appearance.
Indeed.
And also even to the depths where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also able to hear what we, when we speak to our own selves.
Exactly, man. Exactly.
SubhanAllah. This is an amazing attribute.
فَإِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى. If you speak aloud, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is aware of that which is secret and even with that which is more hidden. SubhanAllah.
Shaykh, how about in the Quran, does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speak about, does he mention or does he describe, Dr. Saeed, that he hears the people who are speaking ill of him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who maybe, you know, try to speak, you know, say those things which are improper about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?
SubhanAllah, yes indeed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is everything. And everything, as I mentioned before, that everything in this universe is worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, surrendering to Allah, submitting to Allah, praising Allah, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except the foolish individuals from the mankind and the jinnkind. And some of them, subhanAllah ta'ala, amongst them, they are people who are transgressors, who are deluded, who are deceived, and they transgress against their creator, subhanAllah. They transgress against the one who brought them into existence. Allah ta'ala, the Quran said, أَوَلَا يَذْكُرُ الْإِنسَانُ أَنَّا خَلَقْنَاهُ مِنْ قَبْلِ. Can't man reflect that we brought him, that we created him before, and he was nothing? He was nothing. So they were nothing, Allah Ta'ala brought them into existence. And when they came into existence, they started insulting Allah, the Almighty, their creator.
La ilaha illallah.
See how people are transgressing against Allah, the Almighty. So some people, subhanAllah ta'ala, mentioned in the Quran, who transgress against Allah ta'ala, they give him, for example, a child, Allah ta'ala never had a child. They say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for example, is in need of them. Yeah, they're foolish thinking. I'll give you a story.
Sheikh, we're going to take a quick break, inshallah ta'ala. Sorry to cut you off there.
It's fine.
The time is just, you know, we need to take a quick break, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. But inshallah, we'll come back after this break. We'll hear the story from you, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, stay tuned, inshallah ta'ala. We're going to go for a quick break, bi'idhnillah ta'ala, and we'll see you straight after this. So stay, inshallah ta'ala, stay tuned, because you're going to be hearing the special story from Dr. Sa'id Al-Qadi. We'll see you right after this, bi'idhnillah.
أفلا يتدبرون القرآن ولو كان من عند غير الله لوجدوا فيه اختلافا كثيرا.
We all know that a person's iman increases and decreases, and the best way to increase your iman is through the Quran.
To contemplate, to reflect, to ponder over the verses of the
Quran.
In this program, we will listen to the Quran first, and that should soften our hearts. And then once we get to know the meanings and contemplate over these meanings, then we can change by the will of Allah subhanahu
wa ta'ala. ولا يأتونك بمثل إلا جئناك بالحق وأحسن تفسيرا.
Join us this Ramadan for Quran Circle 2.
Muhammad, the most common name in the world. Why were so many parents interested and still are interested in naming the children Muhammad? What are examples of his love, his compassion, his mercy, his dedication, his sincerity, his bravery? How did he balance between private life and the public sphere of life? Why is he known as the greatest mercy sent to humankind? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, join us as we learn more about the balanced and beautiful personality of perfection, Muhammad.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, welcome back. Before the break, we spoke about the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how He, Jalla Jalaluh, the most majestic, the most high, how He hears those people who speak ill of Him. And Sheikh Sa'id Al-Qadi, mashallah ta'ala, is still with us. He hasn't gone anywhere in the break, mashallah. He's still with us. He was going to tell us a story about the hearing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Go ahead, Shaykh, take it away.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It's a story between Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu and one of the Jewish rabbis in Medina. This man called Finhas, he's a Jewish rabbi, and used to be a friend of Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. Abu Bakr used to speak to him about business matters, but in one occasion Abu Bakr said, let me just speak to him about embracing Islam. And he invited him to Islam, said to him, oh Finhas, embrace Islam and believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his messenger. And you know that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a prophet of Allah ta'ala, and you can find that in your book and in the revelation of Allah ta'ala, and he's covenant to you. He said, oh Bakr, I'm not in need of your prophet, neither am I in need of your Lord.
Allah, look at that, subhanallah.
Subhanallah. He said, indeed your Lord is poor and we are rich. Can't you see your Lord is always asking us for donations and for lending him money? Because he was referring to the verse in which Allah Ta'ala said, من ذا الذي يقرض الله قرضا حسنا, who will lend Allah Ta'ala a good loan.
Totally misunderstood, subhanAllah.
Totally يعني misquoted, misunderstood, twisted, subhanAllah. Allah Ta'ala is saying, who will donate in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who will help those who are in need, and Allah Ta'ala will multiply for him whatever he's given in charity. So he said that Allah Ta'ala is asking us for money. Allah Ta'ala is poor, we are rich, we are not in need of your Lord. So when Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu heard that, he felt outraged from this blasphemy, subhanAllah ta'ala, and he struck him on his face,
subhanAllah,
until he fell down his back. Then he got upset and he went to the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, Messenger of Allah, O Muhammad, your close friend Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu struck me on my face without any reason.
Lying,
yes. Abu Bakr, the Prophet called Abu Bakr, Abu Bakr, why did that? He said to him, O Messenger of Allah, this enemy of Allah, this person has uttered a word, or he described Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with something that I cannot even utter and describe to you. He claimed that Allah ta'ala is poor and he's rich. The man said, by Allah, O Muhammad, I have never said that, and your friend is lying. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, by Allah, O Messenger of Allah, this man has said it and I heard him saying it. Why shall I lie? So while they are there and talking to each other and arguing, Allah Ta'ala revealed this verse. قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ فَقِيرٌ وَنَحْنُ أَغْنِيَاءُ لقد سمع الله قول الذين قالوا إن الله فقير ونحن أغنياء. Indeed, Allah heard the statement of those who said and claimed that Allah Ta'ala is poor and they are rich. سنكتب ما قالوا, we shall write whatever they have uttered. وقتلهم الأنبياء بغير حق, and their killing of the prophets before without any right. ونقول ذوقوا عذاب الحريق, and we shall tell them on the judgment, taste the punishment or the doom of the blazing fire. Subhanallah. So Allah Ta'ala heard them speaking about ill about him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this verse now is recited from 14 centuries. So Allah Ta'ala hears everything. Nothing can be hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
So this is yet another evidence from the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears everything that we say.
Allah hears everything that you utter.
Allahu Akbar. And his hearing is kind of overarches everything.
Exactly.
So in terms of that, he knows everything that's been said, subhanAllah.
He encompasses everything.
So Sheikh, I mean, in light of all of these evidences that you've presented throughout today's episode, Sheikh, how should we conduct ourselves? How should we be when we hear these verses being recited? So our brothers and sisters sitting there at home are thinking about, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can hear everything that we said. Okay, maybe we still haven't internalized it properly. You know, how should this reflect on our day-to-day dealings?
Very important question, Isha. Very important question. This is the main reason of having a show like this.
Yeah.
Which is, what is the impact of this attribute in our life?
Yes.
The main thing is to understand and realize that Allah Ta'ala is overwatching us. Allah Ta'ala can hear whatever we utter. The Nabi of Allah said that إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيْتَكَلَّمْ بِالْكَلِمَةِ لَا يُلْقِي لَهَا بَالًا. A man may utter a word without thinking of its importance, without considering its significance. He doesn't think about it. And this word is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah Ta'ala, for this word, will raise him in ranks in Jannah, will elevate him in ranks in Jannah, just because of one word. So you might utter a word without thinking of its importance.
Yeah.
Allah Ta'ala will raise you in ranks in Jannah because of it. And you might utter a word without thinking of its importance, Allah Ta'ala will write His pleasure upon you until you meet Him.
Allahu Akbar.
SubhanAllah. So, and on the other hand, you might utter a word, same hadith,
yeah,
without thinking of its significance or its importance, and this word will cause Allah's wrath and anger upon you until you meet Him. It's one single word that you utter.
Until you meet Him, Shaykh.
Until you meet Allah SubhanAllah.
Single word.
Single word.
SubhanAllah.
And you might utter a word without thinking of it, and this word will cause you to be thrown in the hellfire on your face for 70 years. رب كلمة يقولها العبد لا يلقي لها بالا تهوي به الناس بين خليفا. Okay, so you might utter a word without thinking of it that will cause you to be thrown in the fire for 70 years. Just by one single
years,
word.
Sheikh.
Single word. So one the star. Word is a responsibility. The word, you can enter Islam with one word, you can come out Islam with one word.
Sheikh, does it also include what we write online, for example, on social media, on you know,
whatever you write,
platform.
Whatever you utter, whatever you say, whatever that comes from your mouth, or whatever you write, subhanAllah ta'ala, is known to Allah Ta'ala, Allah Ta'ala knows it, and it you will be asked about it. Allah in the Quran said, مَا يَلْفِظُ مِن قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ مَا يَلْفِظُ whatever he utters, whatever he utters. مِنْ قَوْلٍ any statement, any word. Okay? Then you will be told whether this is serious, not serious, this is merit, this is a bad deed. But whatever you utter, it's going to be recorded. مَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. And by him, there is an angel who's ascribing, writing, and recording all what he says. SubhanAllah.
How about the things you say to people, Shaykh? You don't say to people, you actually say to yourself.
Allah Ta'ala hears it.
I understand.
But you won't be accountable for it.
Yeah, you won't. Okay.
Okay, Allah Ta'ala.
Let's say you talk about someone, but in yourself.
Yes. That's fine because in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, in the last verse of Baqarah, Allah Ta'ala said, رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا إِن نَسِيْنَا وَأَخْطَأْنَا رَبَّنَا وَلَا تَحْمِلْنَا إِصْرًا كَمَا تَحْمِلُ غَيْرَكَ مِنَّا يعني ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا
به.
Don't burden us with things that we cannot afford. So this is from them.
Okay.
That sometimes you speak to yourself about things as long as you don't realize it, as long as you don't utter it by your tongue, then you won't be accounted. In the sound hadith, Rasulullah SAW said, عُفِيَ عَنْ أُمَّتِي مَا حَدَّثْ بِهِ نَفْسَهَا. That Allah Ta'ala has forgiven my nation for whatever they speak to themselves.
Yeah.
Okay. But other nations, Allah A'lam before us, they might be accountable for that. But for our ummah, whatever I speak to ourselves, we're not accountable for it. مَا لَمْ تَعْمَلْ أَوْ تَتَكَلَّمْ. As long as you don't speak or you don't take an action.
Act upon
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
Sheikh, you know, in today's time, subhanAllah, social media is so, you know, it's everywhere. And you find some people, they're a bit more brazen on social media, you know. They say things they wouldn't normally say in person.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because they're behind the screen, it's in front of a keyboard. They call them keyboard warriors, you know.
Ya Allah, ya
people
Allah.
Who say things online and don't think about it. But in person, in real life, they would never say that, subhanAllah. So, you know, it's created an atmosphere where people are more likely to say things, you know, things which they would never kind of think about, but they're being accounted for.
They will be accounted for, subhanAllah ta'ala. Let's reflect on one verse in the Quran. Allah ta'ala, the Quran spoke about our book of deeds and how to be displayed to us,
yeah.
and how we will see it, and how we'll be surprised when we see it, because that book will not leave anything. That book will record everything, minor, major, anything that you do, or you say, or you utter, you'll find it there. Allah ta'ala in the Quran said, وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابِ And the book will be displayed and given to people.
الله أكبر.
فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا فِيهِ And you see the wrongdoers very scared and terrified from what is inside it. وَيَقُولُونَ مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ لَا يُغَادِرُ صَغِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْصَاهَا How come this book doesn't leave any major or minor? Minor. These, unless it is written there. وَجَدُوا مَا عَمِلُوا حَاضِرًا And they will find whatever they've done is there for them.
Present in front of them.
SubhanAllah. So that means we have to be very careful on whatever we utter, whatever we type, whatever we say. Mu'adh رضي الله عنه, one of the companions, he said to Messenger of Allah, give me an advice. He said to him, أمسك عليك هذا. Control your tongue. Control your tongue. Restrain your tongue. Restrain, control your tongue. Mu'adh said, Messenger of Allah, are we accountable for what we say? Will Allah Ta'ala account us for what we say? He said to him, Oh Mu'adh, may your mother lose you. What are you talking about? Oh Mu'adh, you are a noble person. How come you say that? May your mother lose you. Meaning, you shouldn't say that. What will throw people in the hellfire on their faces except the harvest of their tongues?
Allah SubhanAllah.
May Allah Ta'ala protect us. So
Ameen,
our tongue is very Jazakallah
important. Khairan,
in the sound hadith, whoever guarantees for me his tongue and his private part, I will guarantee
for them. Sheikh, Jazakallahu Khairan. Barakallahu Fik. It's been a beautiful, beautiful episode today, mashallah, tabarak. I learned so much, and I'm sure our brothers and sisters have also gained a lot of knowledge today in understanding the one of the great attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord Allah, the most majestic, the most high, that He is all hearing. So brothers and sisters, put this into practice. Watch what you say and what you write online, and be careful and know that everything is written down. So brothers and sisters, until the next episode, جزاكم الله خيرا وبارك الله فيكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته